Well, a happy and blessed Sunday morning to all of you under the sound of my voice. This is the day that the Lord has made. It's Sunday, and this is the day we prepare for church services. And I trust and hope today that as the churches are now open, you who've been complaining and nagging about going to church, yes, I hope you find yourself in a church service today. It's raining here in Eleuthera, but nevertheless, we give God praise for another day. Today, this is your friend, Minister Rick. And welcome to Moments of Inspiration. I want to talk to us today on a topic called The Lord Will Make a Way Somehow. Hallelujah. The Lord will make a way somehow. There's a song written by gospel artist Hezekiah Walker and reproduced by the Bahamian gospel award-winning group called The Cooling Waters by that same topic. The Lord will make a way somehow. Here's how the song goes. Like a ship was tossed and driven, battered by an angry sea, when the storms of life are raging and their fury falls on me, I wonder what have I done to make this race so hard to run. Then I say to my soul, don't worry, the Lord will make a way somehow. Hallelujah. Yes. For some of you, this song means nothing. This is just words to some of you. You may have never struggled. Never, or you've always had a good job. You've never been battered by an angry sea. You've never been sick or hospitalized. You've never lost a loved one. You've never had a wilderness experience. You've never been broke, hungry, jobless, and without food. But for some of us, we have experienced these times, and we know that by the grace of God, we can tell ourselves that don't worry, take courage, because the Lord will make a way somehow. Yes, I know. Minister Rick knows that the Lord will make a way somehow. And for me, he always does. There's a story in 1 Kings chapter 17 about a Syrophoenician widow and her son who were about to run out of food. She only had a small amount of flour, a little bit of oil, and some water, and she was going to make a last little loaf of bread for her and her son, and then die. Guess what? But God sent the prophet Elijah to her house. My Lord, my Lord, my Lord. Can I speak to some prophets out there today? Has God sent you to anybody's house? Yeah, you, brother prophet, sister prophetess. Has God sent you to anybody's house? You see, sometimes we wait for people to come to us. Come to the church building. Come to me. But God, thank God, God sent the prophet Elijah to the Syrophoenician house. Boy, if she was waiting for the prophet, for her to go to the prophet, that would have been, for her to come to him, that would have been a problem. But the prophet came to her. He told her, here's what he told her. Get me some water. She said, sir, all I have is this oil. All I have is this flour. All I have is this little bit of water to make a cake for me. He said, guess what? Make me a cake first. And he gave her a prophecy. He said, fear not. The Lord says that your oil will not run out until it rains in the earth. She opened up herself and obeyed the prophet. And miraculously, she and her son and her house ate for many days. Obedience to God brings miracles. God kept his promise to the Syrophoenician woman, and he made a way somehow. You see, God wants you to know today. Yeah, you. You. God wants you to know today that you, whatever you've been worrying about, he has already worked it out. Every need is already met. Rest and remain confident in him. Jehovah sees your situation today. Your well will not run dry. He is still in the miracle working business. Trust him for provision today. He will make a way somehow. You see, he knows you're waiting on physical, spiritual, or emotional healing. He knows you're waiting on financial breakthrough. He knows you're waiting on a new opportunity. He knows, Jehovah knows, that you're waiting on restoration. Dry your tears today. Lift up your head today and declare today, I know the Lord will make a way somehow. Yes, 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 I know. Minister Rick knows the Lord will make a way somehow. Philippians 4:19, as I close, says, "And my God shall supply all my needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus." My God shall supply all my needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. My God shall supply all my needs. And he will supply your needs too. Remember, tell yourself today, don't worry, the Lord will make a way somehow. Sila, think and act on these things. God bless you today.